and you're welcome to the Bura-Bari Nwilo show. I'm pretty sure you're probably wondering why I'm dressed in this, but I like it. And the Birdman clothing provided this for me, so I'm renewed, probably your oracle. Hello, you guys are welcome to the second edition of the show, and today I'm with an amazing Nigerian, an amazing Ogoni man. And he is also, you know, setting the pace for other young Ogonis who are coming forth. He is Mr. Nigeria UK. We should have a round of applause in the house and everybody should just clap and stuff like that. Amazing. We have it here. Okay. Now, you know, it is not every day that you grow from contest to being crowned king. Teedum has been, you know, growing from just being a normal model to a crown model and to the pride of a nation and then the pride of a tribe. How has that transition been?
Actually, for the past, I think, 3 months, 2 months now, we've been trying to get the overwhelmingness out of me, if we're allowed to say that. But yeah, it's been exciting and it's been quite a ride, like positively and sometimes negative, because people always talk. It's been exciting actually, and the ride from being just a model to a pageant king is quite hectic as well, because by the time you go from being just a normal model to a king, you're not allowed to reply some certain comments you wish you can reply on Facebook
and
Twitter
Instagram.
And Instagram.
And his Instagram king.
So you're allowed to just read them on but as a model you can actually trash back somebody that trashes you, but as a pageant king and queen you're not allowed to trash back. You just have to, I'll talk to this person inbox or later.
So let's talk about the choice of career.
Yeah.
What were you studying?
I was studying biosciences.
How did you transition from biosciences to modeling?
I've always wanted to get into the entertainment industry while growing up, but I didn't have the chance because everything Nigerians wanted doctors and
Your dad wanted a doctor too.
Not really him though, but my mom. She wanted a professional course, and I was like, okay, all right. Then this opportunity of me going to restless the thing came about, and they were only sponsoring science and economics courses and all that. So I was like, all right, let me just go with that. So I went with that, and that's how I ended into bioscience.
So that's fate.
It's not really fate. It's just me forcing myself to go out of the country. So I'm Mr. Nigeria UK, you know.
And that's cool for you.
God has a reason for everything.
Exactly, yeah, right. So the challenges that I want to bring it home a little bit. Okay. The challenges of being an Ogoni man, crowned king in the UK. Does it add anything to you? Does it make you feel immortal? Like you want to walk with this, you know, with this invisibility?
Since I won my, if you actually check my Instagram and Facebook, you'll see that I actually slept my crowns and sashes. So yeah, I felt so good about it. And being Ogoni as well, I've always wanted to get into the limelight, because we rarely hear of Ogoni celebrities and Ogoni this, Ogoni that. When you tell them I'm Ogoni, they're like, oh, where is that from? I'm like, yeah, you don't can tell me why, everybody knows. We need to go across him, he's dead. Sorry to say that, may he so rest in peace. But he's, we need to go over him. We are more than Kentaramiwa now. Like, we have doctors, we have professors, and we have so many big politicians in Rivers State as well. So it's about time we stop Kentaramiwa. Oh, Kentaramiwa people. No, your people. Oh, Mr. Nigeria people. Yeah, it's time. So yeah, I'm from Ogoni, and I'm here to put us in the map. We're in the map, but we need to be bigger in the map. We need to get into the limelight. We need to get into that celebrity mood. We need to get into that. So that's what I actually joined.
Now tell me about I'm still a bit particular about how you took the bold step to become a model, right?
Yeah,
I know it's wrong way. You started the wrong way, then eventually it went all the way. But it takes some courage, because your mom's gonna call you and say, "Teedum, you know what do I know what
What's
up with that?"
So, it was quite good, because I was lucky to grow up with my parents. My dad is very liberal, though people outside say he's not. But when he comes to the house, he's very liberal. But outside, they're like, I think he's a tough man alive in this sort of house. Yeah, so yeah, he was like quite liberal with us. So I could do anything I want actually. But it's my mom that I was like, oh, mom is going to be sad. But when I got to Rio, I was like, I was about to swear, but I was like, what the? Yeah, she's her life. She's lived her own. She chose what she wanted to do. Yeah. It's my turn to do what I want to do. So I was like, well, it's high time I moved that way. And we had this charity fashion show they were doing in my campus then. And I was like, oh, let me model for them. And I stepped in the room. Immediately, I was working. And the first time, nobody noticed it then. When I was walking back and turned back, it was like screaming there, whoa. And I was like, oh, there's something I must be doing good. So I started practicing my runways properly. Then the next fashion show, somebody was like, oh, you should try modeling. Your catwalks are amazing. So I was like, oh, good then.
And your dance skills are cool too.
I didn't have a male catwalk, so I know what I'm talking about.
But you know, you dance cool, right?
Yeah, I do. I'm a dancer as well. I'm a dancer. I'm a singer as well. So yeah. I'm actually...
You're going to, before the end of the show, you're going to sing a song in Ogoni for me.
Of course. I actually have one I'm going to sing for you guys.
Awesome.
So, yeah,
that's it. Well, I wish you could dance too, but I mean, the frame of this camera
won't
let
you dance. You can come on Facebook or Instagram and see.
Instagram.
And you see me dancing. I have loads of them.
So tell me about your favorite food, because I know you cook and you sneak into your mother's kitchen and then you make something. So, which is your favorite?
In Ogoni, marakuyaye, you know, with the ice fish.
Pounded
vegetable, pumpkin
leaf.
It's pounded, it's cooked and pounded. And it's proper, with periwinkle.
This guy knows everything.
And ice fish.
We should probably not let him go.
Yeah, ice fish.
That's awesome. You make it yourself?
I can make it. I've never made it before, but I can make it. I can make an egusi. For now, I'm very sure of egusi soup, okra soup.
And the egusi wouldn't...
Jollof rice. No, perfect egusi soup that you lick your plate and chew the plate if possible. Yeah, I can do all that. Egusi. Pepper soup as well. Catfish pepper soup, I can make that. Yeah. I make goat soup.
Have you made any since you came out?
No, I've not actually. They don't let me go into the kitchen. My father has been... So, we do more of that. I'll be more laid back and being served, but very soon I should get to the kitchen because I want to cook something for my mom to try. Yeah. Yesterday was her birthday, so I gave her a surprise birthday cake.
So, let's talk about the thing your crown has given to you. Do you think it has put the Ogoni young people in a place where they don't feel like this particular part of the career isn't cut for us? We can be anywhere.
Yeah, we've not really gone there yet. We've not gotten there yet. My crown has not gotten us there yet, but we're planning to get there. But I'm sure they should. You see me as an example. We should blow. We should get into the movies. Get into the modeling. Get into the designing.
What part would you want to play in the movies? The villains.
Me, I would like to play the hero. So people will love me. But I can also do the villain as well. Okay. Because we can be Susanna, and then you can be Ngozi, and then you can be Kitensho.
So let's see the pictures of Okoye.
Yeah. You see that in the next movie.
Cool. It's coming. So talk about your music.
There's one song I actually like. Oh, I'm a lebarubi.
I can't sing to save my life.
Lolo lebarubi. Amen and atopia. Lolo lebarubi. Men akwame. Sime ya loa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We should start a church.
We should actually.
I would be the priest.
No, I actually have the gifts of seeing, so it's gonna be me.
No,
you can be the preacher. You can be the preacher,
and I could be the
financial prophet.
Financial guy.
Yeah. The money should be on him. Yeah.
You know that. I love that part.
Yeah.
Tedum, I really appreciate you coming to the show, and I am sure a lot of young people who are watching will be spoiled and would want to break grounds like you've done. We are very proud of you. You are amazing. We also hope you also, you know, create this brand, this clothing brand too, so people would want to, because I love the way the clothes look on you when you...
Oh,
Alex! Okay, not you again. Okay. I love your the queen.
Okay.
When are you bringing her to
the... We are still sexy.
When are you bringing her
to the... She's coming in April, so we are looking at that. Very soon.
Nice. And I could get a phone.
If you're lucky, you're not kingy, so...
Damn. I could be kingy. I mean, I'm...
How much do you have in your account, then we can talk
but
after that.
They love writers. We don't need to... We are immortal, so they could love me too. She could love me.
Okay, kings are actually more immortal. We live long.
Thank you, Kevin. God bless you. Okay. Stay safe. I like it. Yeah. I like it. Make a little.